here's what you should know about diabetes. I'm Dr. Hertzel Gerstein, an endocrinologist and a professor in the Department of Medicine at McMaster University. Diabetes affects 1 in 10 Canadian adults and 1 in 5 over the age of 65. It is a serious chronic disease that could make you feel unwell today and increase your chance of serious health consequences tomorrow. These consequences could include blindness, kidney failure, heart attacks, strokes, dementia, and cancers, and account for the fact that Canadians spend more than $30 billion annually dealing with diabetes and its consequences. That's the bad news. The good news is that most of these can be prevented or at least delayed by working closely with your healthcare team to individualize the diet, activity, monitoring, and drug regimen that has the best chance of working for you. Diabetes is a disease of high blood sugar or glucose. Your body uses the glucose in your blood to power all of the processes that keep you alive. Things work best when your body maintains a level of glucose within a tightly normal range. When the body's no longer able to do that, the glucose levels rise above normal and diabetes develops. The high glucose in your blood may cause you to feel unwell, and long-term exposure to that high glucose promotes the serious consequences that I've already mentioned. The most important thing to know is that if you have diabetes, it's not your fault. We know that diabetes develops because of a combination of genetic on the one hand and environmental factors on the other hand. We also know that we are currently living in an environment that promotes diabetes in those of us who are susceptible to developing it. But we don't really understand why it develops and why one person gets it and another does not. What we do understand is the how. Diabetes develops when the pancreas in your body is not able to make enough insulin to keep the glucose levels normal. The two broad types of diabetes are type 1 and type 2. Type 1 diabetes accounts for about 5 to 10% of all affected people. In these people, the pancreas makes almost no insulin due to immune damage. Type 2 diabetes, on the other hand, accounts for almost everyone else. In those individuals, the pancreas makes some insulin, but not enough for that person for unknown reasons. Also, about 5 to 10% of women may develop diabetes during a pregnancy or gestational diabetes, and that goes away after the pregnancy. The most important advance in diabetes research in the last 25 years is the identification of many non-drug and drug therapies that have been proven in rigorous, well-done studies to delay or prevent diabetes and to delay or prevent many of the serious long-term health consequences that I described earlier. Much of this research was led by and designed by Canadian scientists here at McMaster University and everywhere else in Canada, who are all focused on reducing and one day eliminating this serious, expensive, and all too common disease.